The roster, Anna, is now set for CNN's two-night Democratic presidential debate event in Detroit. So let's review who's sharing a stage. These 10 candidates will face off the first night, Tuesday, July 30th. And they are Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren. They will join Pete Buttigieg, Beto O'Rourke, Amy Klobuchar, Marianne Williamson, John Delaney, John Hickenlooper, Tim Ryan, and Steve Bullock. On the second night, Wednesday, July 31st, Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, they will join Julian Castro, Andrew Yang, Cory Booker, Jay Inslee, Kirsten Gillibrand, Tulsi Gabbard, Michael Bennett, and Bill de Blasio. There's one more piece of this puzzle that still has to be decided. Coming up, we're going to reveal how the candidates will be positioned on stage each night. Right now, back to Anderson.
All right. Well, thanks very much. John King, David Chalian earlier was talking about Tuesday night, the first night being kind of moderate night. Not so much.
No. Not so much, but it does that after the calculation. Is it these two, Warren and Sanders, against the moderates?
Right.
Or because of just of, they're, again, they're sharing these two, Senator Sanders and Senator Warren, close friends, close partners on many of these issues.
Are they actually close friends?
Yes, they are. And they actually legitimate. Some politicians say they're friends. They're right. Actually close. They're legitimately close. But they're holding 30% of the Democratic Party vote. So is it? Do they defend Medicare for All and other things against John Delaney? John Delaney says it's a bad idea. John Hickenlooper says it's a bad idea. Tim Ryan says I'm not sure we can afford it, although he's more with them than not. Steve Bullock says it's a bad idea. Amy Klobuchar says it's a bad idea. Is it these two against them? Or do we get fireworks between these two? This, to me, is the unanswered question. Mm. At some point, just like Kamala Harris decided, I'm friends with Joe Biden, I like Joe Biden, I was very close with Joe Biden's son, Beau Biden, the only way to get to win is to go through him.
But don't forget.
Does she decide the only way to keep her momentum going is to go through him? Does she do that now? Or does she decide right now is the time to defend the progressives, partner with him, to make the case against them that a progressive can win? Is that this strategy this time? Or is it fireworks between the two of them? And I'm talking about in the context of what does Senator Warren think? What does Senator Sanders think? Senator Sanders is struggling. So, yeah, he's in the middle of the pack. He has an enormous fundraising network. He has a very loyal group of supporters. He can be in this till the very end. But he's, if you look at him vis-a-vis 2016, he's in the teens. Mm-hmm. And so does he decide she's a threat? And she is a threat. Does he decide to air it in the debate? That's my question.
Yeah, just to add to Tuesday, there are some other people on the stage. And they're all going to want to differentiate themselves to a degree because for it's make or break for somebody like a Steve Bullock or a Steve Ryan or a Hickenlooper. And so what they're going to try and do is go after Warren or Bernie and say, look, we are, here's what I believe, and you don't represent the party. So to your point, is that these other people could play into this. Yes. And try and score against these two, and then they could team up together and put off that fight until another day, but we don't know.
It's also worth noting in this, the most diverse field the Democratic Party has ever had, all the first night are white candidates, and the racial diversity is entirely in the second night, which just changes the dynamic, especially because, obviously, race has been a front and center issue in America this week. It has been in this campaign. It is an issue that is sort of coursing through this Democratic primary. And it's just interesting, of course, random draw that it ended up that way with all white candidates on one night and all the
There are ways to differentiate themselves that is not necessarily about Medicare for All. I think that where Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders really could come across as quite different candidates is when you're talking about race, when you're talking about those issues. Senator Warren has been historically considerably more comfortable with them than Senator Sanders has been. So when if they both have a question like that, I think that could be a real opportunity
to differentiate. In that particular vein, I mean, Elizabeth Warren does not have as long of a record as Bernie Sanders does, right? So she's going to go back. She has to decide, you know, does she want to go after him on his vote on giving immunity to gun manufacturers, for example? Does she want to go after him on his opposition to, you know, potentially opposition to reparations, et cetera? Yeah. So that is interesting because he doesn't have as much to go after.
Let's also look at Wednesday night. Yeah. I mean, this, the rematch between Biden and Harris.
This is going to be... But the thrill in Manila, whatever it is, we got the big rematch now. And I think both of these candidates have a lot on the line. Kamala Harris just knocked this guy on his seat. And the question is, and so people say, listen, she got a lot out of it. There's a quiet concern, though. People saying maybe she was too mean. Maybe she's too harsh. She's got to make a calculation. Do I keep doing that? Do I show another side? He, on the other hand, has got to show some spine. And so they're going to be calculating now how tough, how mean, how. And then, but if he gets too tough, then he overdid it. Van, so they've got a big fight.
She's going to be helped by Cory Booker, though. Right. Don't forget, this is the first time that Cory Booker has been on the stage with Joe Biden after he came out. He was so critical of Biden after Biden talked about the segregationists that he worked with in the United States right. Senate. And I think Booker goes after Biden.
I'm sorry.
No, I just that'll be a possibility.
I think we also ought to allow for the fact that even though these matchups are important, and I appreciate the fight night analogies, they all have imperatives strategically. Elizabeth Warren is doing very, very well, but she's doing well with college educated voters, very liberal voters, and young voters. She hasn't broken through with white working class voters, and her message is geared that way. She needs to find. I think she would have liked to have been in the debate with Biden, perhaps to have that discussion about the bankruptcy bill to help burnish her vote there. Kamala Harris did very well in defining herself as a fighter in that moment. It was a very dramatic moment. Of all the top contenders, I think her message is least fleshed out. And so beyond having Biden on that platform, she needs to use that time to tell people exactly what this candidacy is about.
But just to give a sense for our viewers of how high the stakes are, not to use that cliche yet again, how many of these 20 will likely go on to the next debate?
Well, on night two, if you start with night two and you put night two up, only Vice President Biden, let me get this to go here, Vice President Biden and Senator Harris. They're the only two who have qualified so far. Mm. And so for the second debate, you need to be 2% in four qualifying polls and have 130,000 unique donors. They're the only two on this night. So if you're all these others and your fundraising is dependent, you know, money follows momentum. And so if you're them, you're thinking, okay, am I going to be there in September? I have to do something here.
Right.
Which means they're your targets. That's the best way to make news. And the best way to get headway is to go after them. That's night two. So let's clear this out and look at night one. Again, of these candidates who are up on night one, Senator Sanders is in round three, Elizabeth Warren is in, and Mayor Buttigieg is, and Congressman O'Rourke is. So you have more candidates who have already qualified for the next round. But again, there's some big names here. Senator Klobuchar, you know, Governor Bullock is trying to make this his first debate. He's trying to make a name for himself. Sure. Can he? Can he make the outsider argument, I want a Trump state? And can he make it to September is part of the argument here. I also will say this, that I have a question in the second round of debates here about Mayor Buttigieg in the sense that he was the early surprise of this field. He was the guy who shot up. He blocked Beto O'Rourke from the new, interesting, next generational face lane, a guy from middle America. He's plateaued. He's had the police shooting issue back home. He's raised a ton of money. He's had a good he's built a pretty good organization so far, and he's proven he's got the fundraising resources. Where's his play? Where is his play for who am I in this race? And can he's in the top five. This has been a five-candidate race, even though there's 20 qualified for the debates. The leaders, we've had a consistent five at the top of the polls, but he's at the bottom of those five, and he's kind of plateaued. He needs a moment.
Yeah.
What will it be?